It's a first in the entire country. The right to wear your hair however you like is now law in California. It's called the Crown Act, and it's supposed to protect people in workplaces and schools from racial discrimination based on their natural hair and style choices. That discrimination tends to target people of color, mainly black people. So now styles like afros and braids and twists and cornrows and locks are protected. New York City issued a similar ban back in February after Raelene Roberts and other salon employees filed a complaint against their employer, a high-profile salon in Manhattan.
I love being natural because it makes me confident. It gives me freedom. It makes me feel stylish. I feel like I'm not like anyone else. When we were growing up, every time I got my hair done by one of my sisters, you know, it brought us together, like sitting in the kitchen with grandma doing, you know, our hair. It's memories, it's good memories.
Right after college, I began working at Sharon Durham at Sally Hirschberger Salon as a receptionist. I first realized my hair was an issue for Sharon Durham and the workers there when I asked for an evaluation from my general manager at the time. The only negative feedback he gave me was that my hair wasn't straight enough, even though I already straightened it with a flat iron. He said it needed to be a little bit straighter. When I came in to work the next day with the wig, I was told that it looked like a wig. Of course it looks like a wig. My hair doesn't do that. So after I was told that it looked too wiggy and I shouldn't wear it, I left early that day, crying. I felt hurt. I felt like, why am I working here? Why do you want me to work here if you don't like who I present myself as?
Usually hair discrimination cases are not often obvious and you have to do a little bit more digging. In order to prove some kind of discrimination under the New York City human rights law, all you have to show is differential treatment or that you were treated less well because of a protected status.
I think people of color in this country notice very early that there are messages and ideas about their hair and their skin and their appearance. Our New York City human rights law protects against race-based discrimination, and we've interpreted that to include discrimination based on hair. So that might be locks, braids, bantu knots, twists, fades, whatever it might be.
This is not a grooming issue. This is a basic human rights issue. In the last year, we've seen a rise in viral videos of black people being punished or humiliated, pushed out of school because of the way they wear their hair. Last summer, we watched wrestler Andrew Johnson have his locks cut off immediately before he was asked to compete in a wrestling match. The ACLU represented twin sisters in Massachusetts who were barred from their extracurricular activities because they wore their box braids, including extensions. Even though white students at the school were allowed to wear extensions and other hairstyles without punishment.
I think on one level, it's outrage and anger. You know, this is who I am. Why can't I participate in the workforce this way? Or why is my child, you know, my kindergartner, why can't they go to school because they have locks? Underneath the anger, I think there's deep sadness, depression, because I think racial discrimination, hair discrimination is all preventing people from just wanting to live their life.
I know the anxiety that people have after getting their hair done, then like, okay, what's gonna happen when I go to work? Are they gonna say anything?
You know, it's a big thing in the workplace. A lot of people don't want to draw attention to themselves, so they try to do the norm.
A lot of the time I would always get people just like saying how like soft my hair is and everything and like wanting to touch it. That's like always
yeah,
a big
can I
thing.
Touch it?
And like adults doing that too.
Yeah,
and
like grown women, like can I touch it? You know you don't touch no black woman here. No, you
it's
already
like,
know that.
Like, feel like you're in a zoo.
I think many employers may not realize that grooming policies that they have in place are actually problematic. So I foresee our hair guidance being a national trend and maybe even inspire a change to federal law.
I wish Sharon Durham asked me why I wore my hair the way I wore it instead of saying I need to change it. Understand why we wear our hair this way. She could have just educated herself by asking me those questions.
A lawyer for Sharon Durham Color at Sally Hershberger Salon says they did learn a lesson from Raelene's complaint. And while they deny the policy was applied only to African Americans, she says the owners understand that it wasn't sensitive to black people. The case was settled this year.